Hello everyone, myself Dr. Golesh Rushiket. I am working as assistant professor in Department of Geology of Khari Dehri Bhosle College, Guwahati, District Ratnagiri, Maharashtra, India. Today I have delivered lecture on earthquake. What is earthquake? What causes of the earthquake, effect of the earthquake, and intensity of the earthquake, and how to measure the earthquake, and some of the remedial measures of the earthquake. Okay. Earthquake occurs. Felt energy. What is in the earthquake? When earthquake occurs, when energy stored in the elastically stained rocks after due time, it is suddenly released. The stored energy into the elastically stained energy in a rock or in a material and suddenly released from the subsurface. Then form vibration of the then. Some of the vibrations are started called as earthquake. This release of energy causes intense ground shaking. Intense ground shaking in the area near the source of the earthquake. And sends wave as elastic energy called as seismic waves. Okay. What is meant by seismic wave? Seismic waves means elastic energy are released in the form of some vibration near to the surface, parallel to the surface and perpendicular to the surface called as seismic waves. Earthquakes can be generated by the blast, volcanic eruption, sudden volume changes in the mineral and sudden slips along the fault. Earthquakes can be generated maybe blasting, some of the mining activity will be, mining activity is responsible for the regional earthquakes, and some volcanic eruptions are also responsible for these types of earthquake. Okay. And sudden volume changes in the mineral. Suppose the mineral changes, the chemistry of the mineral will be changes, then also this type of geohazard will be taken place. And sudden slip along the fault. What is meant by fault? Fault means the displacement of the two beds. Suppose this is the two beds, A and B. This is the A and B bed. Suppose one bed move away towards upward or for horizontal as well as vertical, so horizontal movement as well as vertical movement, horizontal displacement as well as vertical displacement is called as fault. Fault is one of the very important geological structure to indication of the presence of volcanic activity or earthquake activity beneath the subsurface. Okay, earthquakes are definitely a geological hazard. It is not a natural hazard. It is not a climatic hazard or man-made hazard. Earthquakes are definitely a geological hazard for those living in the earthquake prone areas. But the seismic waves generated by the earthquake are invaluable for the studying of the earthquake, of the interior of the earth. Earthquakes are definitely geological hazard, but one of the only importance of this earthquake, with the help of the seismic waves coming from the volcanic, coming from the earthquake, are essential or useful for the identification of interior of the earth, because of seismic waves are the different types, primary wave and secondary wave. Some of the secondary wave are not passing from the liquidous material. Therefore, these seismic waves are important or useful useful for the identification of the internal structure of the earth, crust, mantle and core. For the geoscientist or seismologist, is very useful information coming from the earthquake waves. Okay. How earthquakes are measured? How do earthquakes measure? When an earthquake occurs, the elastic energy is released. And send out vibration that travels in all directions throughout the earth. These vibrations are called as seismic waves. The vibration of the ground shaking and some vibration is called as earthquake. The seismic waves, also called as seismic waves. These vibrations. The vibration is called as seismic wave. The point within the earth where the fault rupture starts is called as focus or hypocenter of the earthquake. The point within the earth where the fault is ruptured, where the displacement of the bed is called as focus. So sometimes the focus of the earthquake is just below the subsurface. Suppose one of the examples of Bhuj earthquake. Bhuj is the geographical location of that earthquake, and the focus means just below the epicenter. Epicenter means what is meant by epicenter? Epicenter means the geographical location of where the major damage happened, called as epicenter. Also, the epicenter, I will explain in next slide how to locate the epicenter. Actually, epicenter means the geographical location of three seismographic stations. There are seismograms, one of the instruments to identify the recording of the seismic waves, and from based on three different locations and where the three location circles are intersecting at particular location, call as epicenter. So for the epicenter, there is need to the at least three seismographic stations at the particular region to identify the epicenter. And epicenter focus means just below the epicenter. Depth of the that rupture of the fault, that when start the energy release, that is the focus. Focus is just below the epicenter. Suppose this is the epicenter and this is the focus. Okay, just below the epicenter. This is the exact location within the earth where seismic waves are generated by the sudden release of stored elastic energy. Okay, the epicenter is the point on the surface of the earth directly above the focus. Yes, same. Focus is just below the subsurface, just below the epicenter, and focus epicenter means just above the focus, called as epicenter. Seismic waves generated from the focus can travel into all directions. This figure shows terminology of the earth peak. Okay, this figure shows terminology of the earth peak. This dark circle indicates the focus of the earth peak, and this is the on the surface just above the focus, called as epicenter. Okay, what is mean by seismic wave? I already told the seismic wave means ground shaking or vibration of the ground, called as seismic wave. There are two types of seismic waves: body waves and primary waves. Body waves, it is generated from the focus and travel in all directions. The body waves are generated from the focus and travel into the all directions. Suppose this is the focus, all the direction north, south, east, west, and below also. In all direction through the body of the earth. Okay. And there are two types of body waves. Again, body waves, there are two types, primary wave and secondary wave. P waves, also called as primary wave, they travel with velocity that depends on the elastic property of the rock. The velocity of this primary wave depending upon the elastic property of the rock through which they travel. Suppose the elastic property of the rock is high, the velocity of the wave is also high. Suppose in sedimentary rock are present, the velocity of that wave is more than the granitic and metamorphic rock, because of granitic and metamorphic rock is brittle and sediment rock is very ductile. Sediment rock is very elastic than the igneous and metamorphic. Therefore, sedimentary rock terrain is most prone to the earthquake hazards. And another is, primary waves are same thing as sound waves. Same thing as sound waves. Okay, they move through the material by compressing it, but after it has been compressed, it expands. Okay, so that wave moves by compressing and expanding the material it travels. Okay. And S wave. S wave is also called as secondary wave, also called as shear wave. Shear wave, they travel a velocity that depends upon only rigidity, resistance. Difference is between the S wave and primary wave. Primary wave is totally depends upon the elastic property of the rock, and the shear wave are depending upon the resistance of the rock, rigidity of the material, and density of the material through which they travel. Okay. S waves travel through the material by the shearing it or changing its shape in the direction of perpendicular in the direction of travel. Okay. Shear waves. S wave travel through the material by shearing it or changing its shape in the direction perpendicular to the direction of travel. Okay. It is notable that liquids have no rigidity. So that the velocity of secondary wave cannot pass from the liquid media, and therefore our earth crust, earth made up of three layers, crust, mantle and core. Out of that, outer core is totally made up of liquid media, and therefore the outer core, from outer core, shear waves are not passing from the outer core. This is one of the best example of the notable that the liquid wave, no rigidity, so that the velocity of S wave is zero in its liquid material. Note that the secondary wave travels slower than the primary wave, so they will reach seismograph after the primary wave or longitudinal wave. Means first primary wave, P waves are comes on the seismographic station, and then comes the secondary wave or S wave, surface wave. Okay. Surface waves differ from the body wave. I already told the body wave, there are two types, primary wave and secondary wave. And surface wave is parallel to the surface. Surface waves differ from the body waves like primary and secondary in that they do not travel through the earth, but instead travel along the path nearly parallel to the surface. Surface waves are not coming from the mantle, core, mantle and crust, but it is move parallel to the surface like this. Okay. Surface wave behave like S wave. Surface wave behave like secondary wave in that they cause up and down side to side movement as they pass, but they travel slower than the secondary wave. Okay. And do not travel through the bed of the earth. Okay. Surface waves are responsible for much of the shaking that occurs during the earthquake. Surface waves are very responsible for much of the shaking. That means higher shaking is only possible through the surface wave. The study of the how seismic waves behave in the earth is called as seismology. Seismology is nothing but the branch of science which deals with the study of earthquake causes, effect and remedial measure, and different seismic waves called as seismology. In our India, the Seismological Institute of India situated in Bhuj, in the Gujarat. Okay. Seismic waves are measured and recorded on the instrument is called as seismometer. Where the seismic waves are measured and recorded, which instrument is called as seismometer? You see this diagram. These are the compressional wave and shear waves. Compressional wave, P wave, compressional wave, and shear wave is parallel to the earth surface. Okay. And the instrument recorded of earthquake is called as seismometer. I already told surface waves and body waves about body waves two types, primary wave and secondary wave, or secondary wave, and surface wave is also called shear wave. This is the diagram of different waves. This is the P waves, all types of matter fastest, direction of the primary wave. S wave is solid only, second fastest. Primary wave is first, highest, highly speeded, and secondary wave are slowest than the primary wave. Okay. Seismometer. You know seismometer? Seismometer waves travel through the earth as elastic vibration. And this is the diagram of the seismometer. Is an instrument used to record the vibration. You see this diagram. This is the pendulum and this is the graph paper. One of the drums are fitted on this particular, when vibration started, the pencil of that particular drum is continuously moving. When vibration started, then recording these line sketches through the pencil or through the pen, drum like structures. Paper moves in direction along arrow, earth motion to the earth pitch, and then the continuous recorded when vibration started, called as seismometer. Okay. This is the typical seismograph record. This is the noise, means sound. Seismograph papers move in the direction. And when the vibration started, the recording is started and the pin is marked on this drum paper. This type of just cases are started. PVOs arise at first. Then SP line interval means the time between the secondary wave and the primary interval. How much time are required to come secondary waves arise from the primary wave? That is the SP line interval. And then surface waves arise last. Surface waves means shear waves. These are the typical seismograph record. This is another delay between arrival of secondary and primary wave in proportional to the distance traveled by the waves. This is one of the example average travel time curves. You see this diagram. The distance kilometer traveled from the focus, 0 to 20,000 kilometer. Okay. This is the time in minutes. The primary wave at 7 minutes and secondary wave at 13.7 minutes. And SP interval means the time between primary interval and primary waves and secondary waves, called as time interval. Okay. How to locate epicenter? I already told how to locate epicenter. Epicenter means exact geographical location. Suppose in our India, major earthquake happened in 28 January 2001 in Bhuj, Gujarat, and one of the 1993 in Pillai, in state of Maharashtra. The most recent earthquake in India. How to locate epicenter? For locating epicenter, minimum requirement is at least 3 seismographic stations are required to locate epicenter. Suppose one epicenter at Mumbai, for example, one epicenter at Mumbai, one epicenter at Delhi, and one epicenter at Kolkata. When earthquake vibration are all the entire country, then the intensity of particular earthquake. Suppose the Kolkata station recorded one seismometer and Delhi and Mumbai, and intersection point of these 3 seismographic stations is called as epicenter. Suppose this is the area A, B and C, 3 points, 3 seismographic stations are installed, and when the intersection point of this A, B, C called as epicenter. Okay. In addition, we need on further pieces of information, that is the time it takes for primary wave and secondary wave to travel through the earth and arrive at a seismographic station. Such information has been collected over the last 100 years, so and so years, and it is available as travel time curve. Okay. From the seismographic station, at each station, one determines the SP interval and the differences in the time of arrival of the first seismic wave and time of arrival of primary wave. Note that on the travel time curve, the SP interval increases with the increasing distance from the epicenter. Okay, you know? Note that on travel time curve, the SP interval increases with the increasing distance from the epicenter of the particular earthquake. Okay. Thus, the SP interval tells in the distance to the epicenter from the earth. Epicenter from the seismographic station where the earthquake was recorded. Okay. Means for the locating of epicenter, at least 3 seismographic stations are essential. Without 3 seismographic stations, we cannot say exact epicenter point of the particular earthquake. Okay. These are the recording earthquake. These are the pictures showing vertical earth motion and horizontal earth motion. There are 2 earthquakes happen. Suppose one example is vertical earth movement, vertical motion. This is the drum paper. Drum paper is also vertical. This is the heavy weight and this is the spring support and rotating drum. This drum is cannot continuously started. It cannot stop or cannot continuously working whether it is earthquake happen or not. 24/7 the drum is rotating. When just start the vibration, then recording is possible on this drum paper. Therefore, rotating drum are continuously working 24/7. Without working of rotating drum paper, we cannot possible to record exact vibration of the pin. Suppose at early morning and drum paper is not working, the seismogram cannot record the vibration on the paper. Okay, this is the example. This is the horizontal drum paper. When the motion is horizontal, moment, these are the depending upon the moment of direction of the moment of the earth feet. And this is the picture showing how to locate epicenter. Okay, this is the D1, D2 and D3. D1, D2 and D3 is seismographic station. One station D1 at San Francisco, D2 at Palo Alto and D3 at Lick Observatory. These are the three epicenters in the in this area, San Andreas Fault, near the San Andreas Fault area. Suppose this is the intense velocity, this is the D1 circle, this is the D2 circle and this is the D3 circle, and when intersect here, what is the epicenter? Where is the epicenter? Here is the epicenter. Here, where intersection of the D1, D2 and D3 means three epicenter intersecting circle called as epicenter. Okay, this is another example. Suppose this is seismograph 1, this is seismograph 2 and this is seismograph 3. This one. This is the seismograph 1. The total radius of the seismograph 1 is 2000 km. Means from this seismograph station, the earthquake vibration measured up to the 2000 km from this seismographic unit, seismograph station. This is the distance. Another one is the 4000 km. From the seismographic station to up to the 4000 km of seismic vibration will be recorded at this seismograph 2. And the seismograph 3, from near about, from this seismographic unit up to the 6000 km vibration happens, then recorded here. And after 3 seismographs, each plot a circle of the travel distance calculated by the SP delay. SP delay means secondary and primary delay, where 3 circles intersect the epicenter. Okay. Earthquake size. How to measure in the earthquake size? The earthquake size is usually given in terms of scale called as Richter scale. Richter's magnitude is scale of earthquake size developed by the seismologist named Charles F. Richter. Okay. The Richter's magnitude involves measuring the amplitude height. Amplitude means the amplitude between two waves of the largest recorded wave a specific distance from the earthquake. While it is correct say each increase in 1 in the Richter magnitude, there is tenfold increase in the amplitude. 1 increase the Richter scale, suppose 1 Richter scale and 2 Richter scale, difference between 1 Richter scale and 2 Richter scale is tenfold amplitude height increases. Okay. These are the Richter scale charts. Magnitude scale 1 to 8 Richter scale, also depending upon how much energy released from earthquake. Suppose 1 magnitude is energy release 2 into 10 raised to 30 or the energy release, then 2 magnitude is 6.3 into 10 raised to 14 or the energy release. So and so, this is 3, then called as 3 magnitude earthquake, 2 into 10 raised to 16 are the energy release, then called as 4 magnitude earthquake, 6.3 into 10 raised to 17 are the energy will be released, then 4, 6.3 into 10 raised to 17 are the energy release, then called as 5 scale magnitude earthquake, 2 into 10 raised to 10 are the energy release, then called 6 magnitude. When energy release more than 6.3 into 10 raised to 20 hours, when called 7 magnitude, when energy release is more than 2 into 10 raised to 20 hours energy released from that particular earthquake, and when called as 8 magnitude earthquake, when the energy release is more than 6.3 into 10 raised to 23 hours energy released from that earthquake. That is, the earthquake depends upon the magnitude of the scale. and another modified charge suggested by the scientist Mercalli based on the intensity scale. The intensity is from 1 to 10, 1 to 12, 1 to 1 to 11, 1 to 12, okay. And they also compare with the Richter scale. If intensity 1, the Richter scale less than 3. When the Richter scale less than 3, the Mercalli modified intensity 1. Characteristics of the effect of this earthquake, these Mercalli charge, modified charge totally depend upon the effect of characteristics of the earthquake, okay. People do not feel any earth movement if Richter scale less than 3 or intensity 1. If Richter scale between 3 to 5, 3 to 3.5, intensity 2, a few people notice the movement. Some movements are, then intensity 3, people feel movement will be started. And Richter scale between 3.5 to 4. When the Richter scale between 4 to 4.5, they numerically measure as intensity 4. Some people's outdoors may be feel movement. Okay. When intensity 5, almost all people are feel movement will be started. And the Richter scale between 4.5 to 5.5. When intensity 6, the pictures fall off walls. Then plaster in walls may be cracked. And damage slightly in poorly built structure. And when the Richter scale is 5.5 to 6. When the Richter scale between 6 to 6.5, may be happening loose bricks fail from buildings, damages slightly damages or moderately well built building also damage slightly damaged when intensity 7. And then when intensity 8 and Richter scale of the earthquake is between 6.5 to 7, houses not bolted down sit on foundation, towers and chimneys twisted or maybe fall, well built structure also slightly damages, poorly built structures severely damages. Water level of the waves also changes automatically, naturally. When the earthquake greater than 8 intensity and Richter scale between 6.2 to 7. And also Mercalli suggests the intensity 9 when the Richter scale between 7 to 7.2 and the characteristics of the earthquake, well built structures also considerable damages. Houses not bolted down. Some underground pipes also broken. Ground cracking, some of the ground cracks. Serious damages to the reservoir, some of the crackers on the wall of the dam also. And rainfall as intensity 10, when abrupt, the most buildings and foundation destroyed, some bridges destroyed, damages also destroyed, large landslides occur happening, water through the bank of the canal, rivers and lakes, ground cracks in the large area, railroad tracks bent slightly, and when, but Richter scale between 7.2 to 7.5. And when Mercalli suggested the intensity 11 between the Richter scale 7.5 to 8.8, when the most buildings are collapsed, large cracks appear on the ground, underground pipelines destroyed, railroad tracks badly bent, and more than 8.8, the total disturbance of the earth when intensity collapse, 12 intensity scale by suggested by the Mercalli. Okay. And these are the Richter magnitude chart. Already I explained this one. This is the earthquake depending upon how much earthquake happen anyway on the earth. The great means when the Richter scale greater than 8, only annually average one earthquake will be occurred. And major earthquake between the 7 to 7.9 Richter scale may be annually 18 earthquakes are occur on the earth or on the earth. In strong earthquake between the 6 to 6.9, average annually 120 earthquake happen annually on the earth. And moderate earthquake means between 5 to 5.9 Richter scale, nearly annually 800 earthquake happen occurs. Okay. Light earthquake means between 4 to 4.9 Richter scale, near about 6,200 earthquake occurs annually at this Richter scale. Minor means less than minor means the 3 to 3.9 Richter scale, near about 49,000 earthquakes annually occur at this intensity. Okay. And very minor means less than 3 Richter scale, magnitude between 2 to 3, about 1000 earthquake per day happen on the earth. And magnitude between 1 to 2, about 8000 earthquake happen or occur per day on the earth. Okay. These are the earthquake occurrence. These are the charts showing energy released from the earthquake. Suppose the one magnitude earthquake, number of earthquake per year. I already told this. This is the for your purpose. What happens during an earthquake? Actually, we go ahead to the effect of earthquake. What happens during the earthquake? Maybe ground shaking, ground rupturing sometimes. Okay. Ground shaking means ground movement, ground rupture, maybe rupture ground, displacement horizontal and vertical, fire, maybe the fire due to the bending of some gas pipeline and other things, maybe fire also happening due to the earthquake, landslide and debris rock follow, some of the mountains are collapsed due to the earthquake vibration, and nearby the mountainous area maybe the large hazards, and tsunami. Tsunami is also one of the product of earthquake happen below the ocean, then form the high tide due to the oceanic due to the earthquake current earthquake here, the some of the waters are blown away from surface to the atmosphere up to 10 meters, 20 meters, called as tsunami. Tsunami are the giant ocean waves can rapidly travel across the ocean. Earthquake that occurs along the coastal areas can generate the tsunami, which can cause damage thousands of kilometers away on the other side of the ocean. One of the examples in Sumatra in 26 December 2004, I think, in India, but the major tsunami occurs in the southern India, especially. Prediction of the earthquake. How to predict earthquake? This is the effect: ground rupture, ground vibration, fire, tsunami, sometimes dams damages, sometimes floods also occur due to the damages of dam. These are the effect of earthquake. Some of the buildings collapse, bridges collapse, transportation system totally collapse. These are the effects of the earthquake. Means these are the effects. And now we discuss about the prediction of the earthquake. How to predict the earthquake before it happens? Long-term forecasting and short-term forecasting. There are two forecasting will be possible for the prediction of earthquake. The long-term forecasting means long-term forecasting is based on mainly on the knowledge of when and where earthquake have occurred in the past and particular places. Suppose we have data of where the earthquake and how many earthquake and how much intensity earthquake was occurred in the past. Thus, knowledge of present tectonicity, historical record and geological record are studied to determine the location and recurrence interval of the earthquake. These 3 to 4 studies are very essential to the seismologist. Present tectonicity, present tectonic means whether it is the volcanic belt is present, whether it is fall is present, whether it is any plate tectonic movement is present, or historical record means past record of the tsunami, volcanic activity, plate tectonic activity, earthquake activity. Then geological record, presence of the rock, whether it is granite, basalt, igneous sediment, or metamorphic. Presence of geological structure like fold, faults, joints, fracture. It is also important study to determine the location and recurrence interval of the earthquake. Two methods of the earthquake forecasting are being employed as on today, called as paleoseismology and seismic gap. What is meant by paleoseismology? The study of prehistoric earthquake. The study of prehistoric earthquake is called as paleoseismology. And seismic gap means the seismic gap is zone along the tectonically active area where the no earthquake have occurred recently, but it is known that elastic strain is building in the rock. If a seismic gap can be identified, then possible if the seismic gap can be identified, then it might be possible an area expected to have large earthquake in the near future. If the seismic gap is also important, suppose recently earthquake is not occur in the particular places, but it is known that elastic strain is building in the rock. Means elastic strain is building. The characteristics of the rock is elastic strain is increasing in the rock. If the seismic gap can be identified, it might be possible in area expected to have large earthquake in the future, in the near future. Okay. Short term forecasting. This is the long term forecasting. We have it to more than 100 years data. But short term forecasting, in short term forecasting, the short term prediction involves monitoring the process that occurs in the vicinity of the earthquake prone fault for activity that signify coming earthquake. Among the events may be important are the following: tilting of the ground, foreshocks. Foreshocks means after the major earthquake, some minor earthquake may be happen. Measurement taken in the vicinity of the active fault sometimes show that prior to an earthquake, the ground is uplifted or tilted due to the swelling of the rock caused by the strain building on the fault. This may be lead to the formation of numerous small cracks called as micro cracks. This cracking in the rock may be lead to the small earthquake called as foreshocks. What is foreshocks? The magnitude 7.3 earthquake that occurred destroy half of the city, about 100 million inhabitants, but resulted in only few hundred deaths because of successful evacuation. Successful evacuation is very important. Water leveling changes, water level in wells, very important. The water level, periodically water level recording is very important. As rock becomes stayed in the vicinity of the fault, changes in pressure of the groundwater, water existing in the pore spaces and fractured in a rock occur. This may be force groundwater to move higher or lower elevation, causing changes in the water level also. Animal behavior is important. Prior to magnitude 7.4 earthquake in China, zookeepers reported unusual animal behavior. Snakes refusing to go into the near holes, swans refusing to go to near water, pandas screaming, etc. This was the first systematic study of the phenomenon prior to an earthquake, although other attempts have been made repeat predictions based on the animal behavior, there have been no other successful predictions. Another is controlling earthquake. How to control earthquake? Now we go ahead up to the towards the controlling. How to control? How to predict? Now we learn about the what is earthquake, what is seismic wave, what is the intensity of earthquake, what is the magnitude of earthquake. How to identify epicenter, how to identify the focus, what is the effect of earthquake, what is the prediction of earthquake, what is the long term forecasting, what is the short term forecasting, but how to actual happening of the earthquake, how to after actual happening of the earthquake, how to control earthquake, how to control it. Although no attempts have been yet made to control earthquake, we cannot possible today, at today, made to control earthquake. Earthquakes have been known to be induced by human interaction with the earth. This suggests that in future earthquake control may be possible, but may be possible. These are the some past pictures of Haitian girl stands amid the rubble of destroyed building following the 7 magnitude earthquake that devastated Port au Prince, Haiti on January 20, 2010. These are the example of major earthquake happening. These are the another San Francisco earthquake in 1906. You see this diagram. Major all buildings are damaged. Okay. These are the students epicentering. Experiencing the nature of liquefaction after earthquake. Okay, these are the tsunami survivors of among the debris from the earthquake triggered event. These are the examples of tsunami after tsunami. These are the damage caused by the January 17, 1994 earthquake, North Ridge earthquake. Okay, these are the photo. Pipeline has been damaged. The Trans-Alaska oil pipeline was damaged and built up, withstand several meters of the horizontal displacement where it crosses the Daniel Fault during the magnitude 7.9 earthquake in 2002. The pipeline moved as predicted and no oil spill occurred. This illustrates the importance of estimating potential groundwater motion, ground motion, designing the structures to mitigate the risk. Okay, you see this is the actual pipeline, earlierly totally damaged. This is the some historical earthquake, air location depth, estimated magnitude in from China, possibly near about 8,30,000 people have death on Shenxi area of China in 1556. Then Lisbon, Portugal, 70,000 loss of life. Tsunami damages extensive in 1755. Then another major earthquake happened in the New Madrid, Missouri, 7.9 Richter scale magnitude in 1811 to 1812. Then Charleston, South Carolina, 60 greatest historical earthquake in 1886. Then San Francisco, 1906, near about 3,000 deaths and 7.5 magnitude. Then Italy, near about 1,20,000 people was died in 1908. In Tokyo, Japan, 1,43,000 deaths occurred and 7.9 magnitude scale earthquake happening. And most of the caused extensive destruction in 1923. Then southern Chile, near about 5,700 deaths occurred in 1960. North American earthquake, greatest North American earthquake, Alaska, 1964. These are the different examples of earthquake. In our India, 1993 Latur earthquake in India, 10,000 deaths occurred, located in the table continent interior. This is one of the examples of table part is also facing the earthquake activity. There are two parts of the continent, unstable continent and stable continent. The Deccan trap is one of the example of stable continent, but stable continent are also affected by the earthquake. It is not necessary whether it is part is stable or not stable. Okay, stable and non-stable means tectonically stable or tectonically unstable part. Tectonically Deccan trap is stable, but earthquake is happened in 1993, one of the. Then another example of India, 2001 Bhuj, 25,000 plus deaths occurred, near about 7.9 magnitude earthquake happened. Pakistan, Kashmir is also 86,000 people has been died in 2005. These are the different data of the past earthquake. Okay. Okay. Thank you.